Diseases caused by fungi and other pathogens are always a concern for Christmas tree growers. Although diseases can technically be caused by environmental conditions, for our purposes, we'll define a disease as an infection by a pathogen that interferes with normal growth, leads to the development of symptoms, and can cause damage or even tree death. Every grower wants a perfect plantation without any disease problems, but of course that doesn't happen very often. With a little background, though, we can understand the main types of diseases that we're likely to encounter, how severe they are likely to be, and what we can do when they appear. We can divide the most common diseases we see in Christmas tree plantations into a few main categories. We'll talk about needle casts, rusts, root rots, canker diseases, and tip blights in that order. Needle cast diseases cause needle loss, generally on older needles. The disease cycle usually starts with springtime infection of new growth during wet weather, with another year required before those needles actually drop. Wet conditions around the time of bud breaks are important for disease development, so next year's needle cast problems are greatly impacted by weather conditions this spring. Although needle casts rarely kill trees, they do reduce growth. They also make trees look thin, less attractive, and potentially unmarketable. Here we can see a classic needle cast presentation. The lower branches of this fir are more affected, and only the older needles are at risk. The fungus takes a full year to grow inside infected needles before the symptoms appear. As we move up the tree, we see less of a problem because the top gets more sun and better aeration. And because the spores tend to rain down onto lower branches rather than move upward against gravity. Accurate and timely diagnosis is an essential practice and step when dealing with a needle cast is to have a proper diagnosis done by your local plant diagnostic lab. Typically, your lab report will include treatment options and possibly spray recommendations. Timing is important. Most protective fungicidal sprays are applied shortly after bud break when infections tend to occur. Rusts are a second category of diseases. Most rusts have complex life cycles that require another type of plant to complete. For example, there are three different rust diseases on balsam fir. One requires chickweed, one blueberry, and one fern as alternate hosts. Like needle casts, rust diseases rarely kill trees, but they tend to make them less visually appealing. So they are a concern to growers. And as with the needle casts, having a positive diagnosis made in the lab is a good first step. Removing the alternate host can be an effective way to reduce disease pressure without fungicidal sprays. Broom rust. Here we see broom rust, which is caused by a fungus that needs chickweed to complete its life cycle. Chickweed is shown in the pot next to the tree for educational purposes. We don't recommend doing this in your plantation. Controlling chickweed in and around the field would reduce the number of rust spores in the area, leading to less broom rust in the plantation. Root rots. Root rots are another category of diseases. Rots can be caused by different types of pathogens. Some, such as Phytophthora, do better in wet soil, so we tend to see more of these diseases lower than landscape or in areas with poor drainage. Others, like Armillaria, can be particularly severe in stressed trees. For example, trees grown on poor sites or sites that they are not adapted to, or previously forested sites. Root rots can kill trees and tend to persist in the soil, so they can present serious challenges to growers. Maintaining proper drainage and growing disease-resistant varieties are an important component of integrated pest management when dealing with these issues. There are few pesticide options for root rots. Trees that are infected by Armillaria fungus usually turn a bright reddish-brown color. White tissue, called mycelium, is often visible around the soil line with a little investigation. Canker diseases also warrant some attention. Various fungi can cause cankers on stems and branches. Cankers are basically dead areas under the bark. Some canker diseases can be fatal or at least reduce growth and cause deformed, unsalable trees. Reducing stress can be an effective way to minimize canker diseases. The following slides discuss the canker disease in more detail. Here we see a balsam fir with a dead top but live branches in the bottom 3 feet. Keep in mind that there are other agents that can cause this type of damage, like Phytophthora root rot, environmental factors, and/or chemical applications. Examining the tree closer, we suspect a canker because of the off-color dead branches and the round grayish-blackened sunken area on the trunk. Sure enough, the canker is really a zone of dead plumbing system that has cut off water flow to the top of the tree. Can a tree with cankers be managed? Unfortunately, the answer is no. You will want to cut and destroy the tree, exhibiting symptoms, and refrain from planting in that area. A number of fungi can cause the tips of branches to die during the growing season. Weather conditions in the spring and early summer have a big effect on how much tip blight we see, with wet weather favoring the disease. Tip blight symptoms look a lot like frost damage, but they show up later in the season. It's a good idea to send a tissue sample to your diagnostic lab for diagnosis and recommendations. Often tip blights are just a minor cosmetic issue. Delphinella tip blight of balsam fir tends to appear in July. This disease causes slightly chlorotic needles to appear on new shoots in spring, and as the fungus progresses, the needles may be girdled by cankers at their bases. Finally, as the fungus moves into shoots, they begin to wilt and shrivel. Although it can look alarming, it is rarely serious, and routine shearing is all that's needed.